professional.
It's because I make the song list. I was 23, I was married to a widow who was pretty as could be. This widow had a grown-up daughter who had hair of red. My father fell in love with her and soon they two were wed. This made my dad my son-in-law and changed my very life. For my daughter was my mother, for she was my father's wife. To complicate the matter, even though it brought me joy, I soon became the father of a bouncing baby boy. My little baby then became my brother-in-law to dad, and so became my uncle, though it made me very sad. For if he was my uncle, then that also made him brother of the widow's grown-up daughter, who of course was my stepmother. I'm my own grandpa. Wife then had a son who kept them on the run. Then he became my grandson, for he was my daughter's son. My wife is now my mother's mother, and it makes me blue, because although she is my wife, she's my grandmother too. If my wife is my grandmother, then I'm her grandchild. And every time I think of it, it nearly drives me wild. For now I have become the strangest case you ever saw. As husband of my grandmother, I am my own grandpa.
I'm my own grandpa. I'm my own grandpa. It sounds funny, I know, but it really is so. Oh, I'm my own grandpa.
By the way, where's our mailbox?
We already discussed that.
We, for all these years, we've had a mailbox up here for requests. I wonder why I weren't getting any requests.
How about come sit by the riverbank with me? That's good.
Tell you what, we'll do that right after this one. Thank you, George, for requesting that. Here's one we used to do all the time. We haven't done it too much lately, but we must have had a request for this. No mailbox. Anyway, this is...
No, it's Return to Sender.
Return to Sender. I know that Elvis version. This one's called Rocky Top, Tennessee. They lost.
up Tennessee. Rocked up Tennessee.
Sit by the river, and despite my remarks earlier, I did at one point try and write some songs, and wrote a few, and this is one of them. I wrote this kind of thinking of my grandfather. My paternal grandpa used to take me down to the Charles River by Normbega Park in Auburndale, Massachusetts. A lot of people don't know it, but the MTA ends in Auburndale, at least it did 100 years ago. And we get down there and feed the ducks and trap pigeons, and that day you could trap a pigeon in a basket and take it home for half a day and play with it, you know? Who cared? But anyway, he was kind of my inspiration for this, and it kind of occurred to me that his memory is, you know, when my generation is gone in our family, it's kind of poof, right? There'll be nobody who actually knew him personally, but I did. He was born in 1880, probably. Anyway, it's one called Sit by the River.
I can see that you're ready to go home. There's some TV show that you're missing, but you know how an old man loves to talk, and he needs someone who will listen. Come and sit by the river with me for a while, and I'll tell you a story that's true. So green and the water so blue.
river flow, rolling down from the hills to the ocean. I have seen the waters high, almost fearsome rushing by. I have seen it nearly dry and without motion. And now at last you can see what it has come to. We've prospered but poisoned the waters. Now the tunes have all been played and the piper must be paid, not by us, but our sons and our daughters. Come and sit by the river with me for a while, and I'll tell you a story that's true of when I was a boy playing here on the shore. The grass was so green and the water so blue. Thank you very much, and thanks again for coming out and supporting the RFD boys. With your help, we will survive and move on toward our 50th anniversary. We're going to have some kind of a party once we hit 50, I think.
We'll get drunk and be somebody.
We will finally get drunk. Well, no, we will. We always, yeah, we'll get drunk and we'll be somebody. This is the time of night, boys, where it's the last chance to address the audience. Paul, besides your genealogy, what would you like to tell this crowd?
Do all the exercises that I've told you to do.
It finally dawned on me toward the end of last year, the secret of the RFD boys' longevity is Paul's patience. They all come down here hoping to get their neck tweaked or their hip touched or to hear a stupid joke. And the cover charge is much less than his office charges. How about you, Brad? What's next for you? Were you in the Olympics?
Not yet, but we'll see. See if that call comes in. I don't know. Now I'm gonna figure out how to be in a bank commercial. That's what I'm gonna do.
You have to wear a tie?
I don't know. I don't even know what time I'm supposed to show up yet. It's on Wednesday. Yeah. Are they gonna make a shave? I don't know that either. Actually, all I know is that it's like a young couple going to the bank to learn how to balance a checkbook. So that probably means I'm the dumb guy in the relationship. That's probably what it is. So stay tuned to your local channel.
We will be looking for that.
But I can see
that. You can report on this next month, because we're here again April 13th.
Friday the
13th. They were the same lineup here.
Yeah, I'll let you know.
Okay. Yeah, so actually, bring your fiddle, because you know, you could just whip it out.
Yes.
Oh, I've got plenty of interest.
You mean the commercial thing? Oh, yeah.
Well, if you could put on a wig and you guys could enact it for us.
Right.
And you can tape it.
Does that mean I have to shave too?
Daniel, what about you? You got any smart?
Nope.
Taught that boy well.
I got a lawyer.
Willard, what about you?
Better to be thought a fool than open your mouth and remove all doubt, right?
I won't say anything. I could talk about my fried chicken franchise that I'm going to start up now. Willard's Fried Chicken. Yeah. It's rent to own.
I'd thank George Kilbreath as well.
Yeah.
Okay, we got one more number. What do you boys want to do? Do you want to do Blackberry Blossom?
Or no, no, no. I thought we were going to do Sally Gooden.
Oh, Sally Gooden, yes.
Sally isn't
good. All right. So hopefully we'll see some of you folks back here April 13th. And for those of us who are Michigan basketball fans, I don't even want to know what the score might be. I assume that game has started.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Too much, too little,
yeah. Okay, here's one called Sally Gooden, and then good night all.